One of the technologies we've been having a look at on the show floor here is XD, which is the dual cell LCD technology. First shown last year, I missed it last year. I walked past the stand and completely missed it. Big push this year, it's front of stand, it's all over the place. Not coming to the UK though, is it?
It's not, unfortunately. I think ULED XD continues to sort of be pushing the boundaries, we carry on doing that. You've seen that across whether it's ULED XD or our laser TV proposition. We do have a rolling up laser TV as well this year, which is pretty cool. In terms of ULED XD, it won't be coming to the UK this year. However, 2021, it might be potentially on the roadmap. It's still quite an early concept of technology, so we'd like to iron things out before it really hits the market.
And I guess, I'm presuming this, but as a brand, Hisense need a halo product. That seems like the obvious choice for a halo product to bring into the UK and get people talking about your brand.
Absolutely, you know, there's always the halo products, and we have been trying that with things like the laser TV. We've got 100-inch, 120-inch in the UK at the moment. And I guess in terms of building the brand out, yes, we do want that one product that creates a bit of a halo, but at the moment we carry on continuing with ULED. And then in terms of the brand proposition as well, we are a sponsor of the Euro 2020 this year, so we've got an exciting 7-8 months ahead of us, so we're confident. I think the brand continues to grow, and we're excited on the journey we have.
Big lineup for 2020. Maybe you'll take us through the TVs from mid-range and up.
Yeah, absolutely. So starting at our top end of our TVs, we've got the U7Q, which is our first QLED proposition that we have. So you can see from here, it's this TV here. It's a really nice slick design. It's got a JBL front facing soundbar as well. It's got a UHD premium badge as well. So it'll hit around 1,000 nits of brightness. Comes loaded with Dolby Vision, Dolby Atmos, as well as HDR 10 Plus support as well.
So obviously it's just January. Are you ready to talk prices on these models yet?
Yeah, so these models will start coming to the market in around Q2. As for prices, in true Hisense fashion, we're very competitive, so watch this space.
So what was the reason for going QLED this year then?
I think it's just the way the technology is evolving. We did trial OLED, we had that. I think with QLED we can still play around with backlight technology, and it still stays very true to our ULED proposition, which is our own proprietary, which we carry on backing.
So the next model down is?
So the next model down we have is the U7Q. That has a slightly different stand design. It's a unibody panel as well on the back, so it has one piece of metal that goes right around the back and stretches around the panel itself, so making it look very thin. In terms of brightness on that, it'll hit around 700 nits of brightness. It has a HDR 10 Plus, Dolby Vision, Dolby Atmos as well. And again, carries that quantum dot technology within that.
And again, you're not going to talk prices, but it's fair to say that those sets, the 55, would be under a grand?
So in terms of price points on that, they'll remain competitive across the market. It comes in three different screen sizes. So again, I don't think any Hisense fans out there will be disappointed. It will be a very good price.
And that one again is QLED, yeah?
That is QLED as well, yeah.
Okay, and then we have the sort of mid-range entry point for the higher end TVs, which is you'll explain this, but you've changed the lettering in the TV system, but it replaces the B7500.
That's correct. So the range for 2020, we're shifting back to a global naming convention. So it's called an A7500, is that model. It replaces the B7500, so it seems as though we've gone back a letter, but it is a 2020 model. That itself is a mid 4K TV, around 300 nits of brightness, comes with Dolby Vision, doesn't support the other formats, but it is Dolby Vision supported. It comes in four different screen sizes. It's got a unibody design, so a really nice slick design to the TV.
Now, lots of questions on the forums. Obviously, the forums is a global site, so we have many visitors from all over the world. And lots of questions between the US models and what we get in Europe. So how do you decide which models are available in Europe, and why are those sometimes not as future heavy as the US models?
So some of the models vary between the US and the UK. I guess it's down to sort of the consumer demand. We see that our consumers in the UK demand certain features. I think from a feature set, we pretty much are aligned. It might just be that OS is slightly different. So the US guys have Android. We will carry on with our Vita. More recently, we've adopted Roku as well. So we see a slight difference there, but spec for spec, they're all very similar.
And just coming back to the two QLEDs for a second, it's interesting you bring these to the market. Last year, a lot of the sets were direct lit or edge lit. These are full array local dimming.
That's correct. So we've actually, for the 2020 range on the QLED, we've got direct lit TVs with backlighting as well, so it's full array. So it really gives it that punch of the picture, gets a really nice level of brightness in there as well.
And are you going to tell me how many zones of dimming you have?
Good question. So it varies. Some of them have about 240 and then it goes down to a smaller amount. But yeah, it does vary.
So let's move on to smart TV proposition. You're using Vida version 3.
That's right. So all of our 2020 range will carry Vida U 3.0. That's an upgrade from last year, which was 2.5. So we'll see some updates to the home screen, some of the app content on there as well. It just remains our own system. It's nice and speedy. It's fast. It's intuitive. So we continue to back that.
And tuner-wise, is it Freeview Play?
That's correct. So all our TVs are standard carry Freeview Play. And that's the latest version of Freeview Play. We see that very much as a hygiene for the UK. Consumers love that. And we continue with Freeview Play.
And Arun, you mentioned it's a big year ahead, the Euros. You've sponsored a number of tournaments now. So what do you have in store this year?
Yeah, we're going into our third major tournament. So Russia 2018 was really successful for us. And we continue with Euro 2020 in June, July this year. So a lot of the range you can see here will be included in a promotion that we're looking to do. Anything from 7,500 up. You go on and purchase one of them fantastic TVs and you can be in with a chance of winning tickets. So there are seven games at Wembley. England are going to be playing three of them there. So it's a great chance to see the home nation play at Wembley.
You do know that although I've got a Scottish accent, I'm actually English and I'd love some tickets.
Well, good luck Scotland. We hope they get through in March.
Well, Arun, all the best for CES. It's a great stand. You've got the European side here. The other side, you've got all the fancy laser TVs and everything. It's been fascinating looking around. Have a great show.
Thank you very much, and Happy New Year to all the forum members.